from where is it?
The name is Carlos Pires. Carlos Pires. Carlos. This is really great. Are you subscribed to the Debian mailing list? But you are aware that there is a Debian mail project and so. The thing is that we just started this project. I was in my talk today. Have you seen the talk of? Yes. So the Debian Mint project is just for 6 years, and we try to gather people who are somehow connected with cleansing. Also, biological software. So, and we have a lot of biological software. Task, for instance, you can browse the other tasks, and you can see what we have in Debian, and also what we want to have. So this is a nice color scheme. You have several. The green ones are the packages which are just in Debian.
In green, that's
in Debian.
In Debian,
it is included. It is just on.
Yes.
And the yellow ones are those packages which are just featuring either unofficial packages. Yeah, or if there are some packaging stuff in S4N where we're working on.
Okay.
Yeah, or experimental packages also. This is our current list which has to be done. And the red ones are those which are interesting project, just listed here. Even further on the to-do list. Search for Debian Mate in general, just ask Google for Debian Mate.
also a link to this page, or should be at least.
This is the one you...
Yeah, yeah, yes. Yeah, I'm reading this kind of thing. This is the main entry point. Yes. And this, should be, these are static pages, and we want to move them to this dynamically created pages. Because it's a static page, it's unmaintainable. And so the plan is to remove all these links to this...
To this place and have...
To have some entry page to give some information about the project and everything else. The technical stuff is on this Elliot project. This is what, where you can easily see what we really are doing. And if you see something you would like to do, I would really appreciate if you would subscribe to the mailing list. It's not so high traffic. It is increasing, but well. The goal is finally to find a system which makes any use in medical care. It is your hospital or whatever, all small practices, and we have a lot to do. It is not that you can start and you hand out the CD and then you can work on it. It is not finished at all. But we started from zero, and, well, we have good progress. Verification how it works. If it's okay, you need the running MUMS. So like this is GCC compiler. You bootstrap from somewhere and then you have to start with something. This is a technical problem, and the other problem is we have nobody to test. I don't know what to do with this stuff. This Vista would be a really big deal if we I just talked to this Vista guy, so they told me, well, we have no problem even dived so deep into this, because I thought if we would manage to build a Debian package from this month stuff, then we could try to understand this, but
yeah.
I didn't spend so much time into it. So
yes.
It is probably, this is a kind of a killer application for Debian Mint, but we have not enough manpower to tackle this problem. If we had a team of 5 people working
yes.
on this,
yes.
I would be really happy, but
yes.
we just would put some technical burden on our backs for nothing, because we would not succeed. So. If you would have if you know a hospital who wants to run this stuff, they could pay 5 developers and work on this. I would really support this, but it can only be done with this paid work also.
These 6 developers are involved in medical.
No, I mean, I think about if you know a hospital, yes, which wants to use this program, they could make an advertising, we are hiring people, and these hired people could do the work which I could describe what has to be done, but I would rather spend my time on projects where I know that I can finish them.
Okay.
This is, it makes no sense to work on this. Some own software which could be packaged or included in Debian, so it's fine. But this would be nice if you are subscribed, if you make a small introduction, I'm Carlos, I am doing this and this, and then you join the project and my interest is this and that. And so that people now need to know. There are about 20 active people. There are, I subscribe, perhaps 100 or 150, I don't care. But 20 people are really active, and it's nice to know each other.
Okay.
That's awesome. I think we could just join the other talk, and there's no need to
continue with it.
What's nice that you showed up. I think it's better to have a single person to talk to and which really wants to work than 10 people who just want to. If you are showing up in the Debian conference, you have some interest in wanting to do something. From which town in Argentina are you coming from?
Yeah, Buenos Aires.
Buenos Aires. So everybody comes from Buenos Aires. No, he's German. His name is Meyer. He is a German.
Yes.
He doesn't come from Buenos Aires.
I work in Buenos Aires. Yes.
We just finish our BOF workshop, whatever.
Today.
Yeah. But I'm very happy with it.
At least one.
I did not expect it much more. We did it in Edinburgh, and there were basically 4 or 5 people just sitting in the room, and 1 or 2 people who said they would join, but I've not heard so much. The problem is that it's a very specific topic, and you have a very small common set between free software developers and medicine people. This small common set is we have to catch these people.
Yes.
Down, and there's a link to the English page, and then I can read it, and then it will point it to me.
Is that right? But this is just.
Ah, just not a subscription.
Yes,
come on.
It's good for institution because you will put spend much less money in
system,
and you can do a support to
one Brazilian developer on this list, and so I would like to increase the number of developers here in South America also, because I think there is much power there. It's in some South American countries there are hospitals which are running with free software. I have read about it, but I don't really know.
Yes, I know many people that develop for kind of software, but
but in principle, especially medical software should be free to know where the data go around. And
it's the ideal is that there was one standard, something like that.
Yeah.
But now,
you know, there is some free in here software for. In Germany, for medical practices, so the management software is free for the doctor, free in SMB, and it is paid by the pharmaceutical industry. And if you want to make a subscription, you can guess which medical product is listed on top.
Yes.
And this really sucks. This really sucks.
Yes, the pharmaceutical industry is big.
Yeah.
All is covered with it.
Yeah.
But, yes, I know people working on this kind of thing, and many software is in MS and Microsoft.
Yeah, sure.
One thing that's very important, I see many evolution in Linux, Kia, some projects, is about protocols about image transmission.
Mm-hmm. We have some DICOM viewer, the DICOM library, this is also included.
In Germany, they have one implementation that is free, but free in the
free as a DR.
Yes, because you have to fill one form. The API, and you can start to use, but then you have to sign one confidentiality use. It's not free already.
Yeah, but we have some.
I know why.
She's in my party. we have some econ libraries in DebianMed and some econ viewers. So there is medical imaging is quite good covered compared to other areas. So
this is much software in modern hospital. You need to write information with system database and medical histories.
I finished
the.
Go. Okay. So it was nice to meet you. If you have any other questions, so ask me in the conference with you.